Welcome to Ayurveda Network. Myself, I am Dr. Satya N. Dornala. I will discuss about updates in diabetology and Ayurveda's perception. We all know that due to technological innovation, we could see day-to-day developments in the different fields of healthcare. Similarly, as this particular clinical condition is more prevalent in the society, so we could see more updates in day-to-day healthcare technology. Being an Ayurvedic doctor, how we receive and perceive the things with respect to the Ayurvedic understanding. If you look at this slide, we could see Indian God, Lord Vigneshwara. We all know he is very fond of sweets. You could see a laddu. In Indian language, we call it as a laddu in the left hand. And he is very fond of sweet. And he also have the habit of taking, whenever he consumes the sweets, he has habit of consuming these two fruits given in the bottom left and the right. Bottom left side, it is the wood apple, and the right is the jamun, blueberries. And the different studies reported also shows that both the fruits doesn't allow the intestinal sugar to be absorbed into the bloodstream. So that's how blood sugar will be maintained. And even in the Chakrarata, it is also written that Lord Vigneshwara suffered from diabetes, and Lord Shiva, his father, prepared a specific formulation for him, that's by name Shiva Gulika, and given to him, and he get rid of that disease also. So that's how the diabetes is, the disease is not of this era only. This is since the ages of mythological stories. Next, please. This particular article, maybe the editorial titled as Diabetes, an Ancient Disease, Epidemic and an Economic Burden for the Present Era, published in the year 2016 in the Journal of Indian Journal of Medical Research. And that too, this editorial was published on the occasion of World Health Day, that is April 7, 2016. When I read this article, though the title is mentioned, of article is mentioned as an ancient disease, all the literature related to the claiming this as an ancient disease from the different cultures, knowledge of the world was mentioned in the article. But though this particular article is written by an Indian, and though it is getting published, they got published in the Indian journal, but they could not mention the Indian knowledge, that is Ayurveda. So even on my, when I read this article, I felt bad, and even I communicated with the author. So he assured that he will take care in the future publications. Next, please. So this is another editorial published in the world's one of the top journal, that is The Lancet. This is also the editorial published in 2017. The interesting aspect of this editorial is they have mentioned about the Ayurvedic contribution in the very first two lines. That is, if we could see, the distinction between the type 1 and type 2 diabetes was described as early as 500 to 600 BC by Indian physicians Susuta and Charaka. So that's how the Indian perception, particularly the contemporary physicians towards Ayurveda, shows how the world is looking at and how the Indian doctors are looking at Ayurveda. Next, please. Coming to the introductory part, India's greatest achievement is longer lives. The reason is, if you look at this table in this slide, the average life expectancy in 1947 was 31 years. Now, over these years, currently it is almost, it has touched 70 years. It is more than a double. If you try to look at this development from the aspect of health economics, it is definitely this worth of billions and trillions of US dollars. And the factors which contributed for this doubling of this average life expectancy is, there are many, out of which immunization and nutrition plays a pivotal role. So that's how we could able to successful in adding years to life, that is lifespan, but at the same time in this race of achieving this success, we forgot to achieve life 2 years, that is health span. Particularly in terms of lifestyle disorders and chronic non-communicable disorders such as cardiovascular disorders, cancers, diabetes and COPD. If you look at the right bottom image, almost 2/3 of Indian population are at the risk of pre-diabetes phase. Next, please. There is a report published in the year 2017 in the month of November by Indian Council of Medical Research, titled as India, Health of the Nation States. And they assessed over the period of 26 years from 1990 to 2016. And when you look at the health of the states, they found that in the year 1990, almost 53.6% was the communicable disease. And now this 53.6% reduced to 27.5%, and earlier the ratio of non-communicable disease was only 37.9%. Now it is almost nearing to the double. Over the 26 years of period, the transition of disease pattern, the change from communicable disease to the non-communicable diseases, and particularly diabetes and hypertension and so on. Next, please. So this may be the reason the national health policy revised in the year 2017, shifting the focus from sick care to the wellness, and that too focusing the participation of all the available knowledge systems, healthcare knowledge system, that is considered a pluralistic healthcare. The main objective is to achieve the highest possible level of good health and well-being through a preventive and promotive healthcare orientation in all developmental policies. And to reduce premature mortality from chronic non-communicable disease by 25% by the year 2025. Next, please. Epidemiology and public health. Next, please. Transformation of the world. Now, the world is being transformed on day-to-day basis. And this transformation is because of a digitalization. As the digitalization is the key to the transformation. Is the digitalization is making the world as diabetization is making this world to move towards diabetization also along with the digitalization? as digitalization making the lives more and more sedentary. Next, please. World Health Day. In the year 1981, the theme of World Health Day was Health for All by 2000 AD. But by 2000 AD, we could not achieve that health for all. In turn, maybe this health for all has become a disease for all. And almost after the 4 decades, again WHO taken up the task of health for all as a slogan for the year 2018. Next, please. Sustainable Developmental Goals. There are 17 goals identified to transform our world in the year. There was an, as said in the previous slide, in 1981, it was decided to have a health for all by 2000 AD. But by 2000 AD, that could not be achieved. Again, it is redesigned to Millennium Developmental Goals. There are 8 goals, and that is supposed to be achieved by 2015. And when we reached 2015, even that could not be achieved properly. Again, it is redesigned to the Sustainable Developmental Goals. There are 17 goals and the target is 2030. And in these Sustainable Developmental Goals, 17 Sustainable Developmental Goals, Goal 3 is ensure healthy lives, promote well-being for all at all ages. And target is by 2030 reduce 1/3 of premature mortality from non-communicable disease through prevention and treatment and promote mental health and well-being. Next, please. Every year, November 14 is celebrated as a World Diabetes Day. And this particular Diabetes Day is declared by United Nations. And this started in the year 2007. Even UN identified and declared an official symbol for diabetes, that is blue ring. And for the year 2018 and 19, the theme is family and diabetes. So it is to emphasize the role of family in the management of the diabetes. Next, please. There is a study published in Indian Journal of Endocrinology and Metabolism. It was an ongoing study, and they found in the rule of 2/3 in diabetes epidemiology, particularly in the Indian context. The rule of 2/3 is 2/3 of dysglycemia is pre-diabetic, 2/3 of pre-diabetes convert to diabetes, 2/3 of people with diabetes are undiagnosed, 2/3 of people with diabetes do not achieve target, 2/3 of people with diabetes have hypertension, 2/3 of people with diabetes have dyslipidemia. That's how this they could found the epidemiological trend as rule of 2/3. Next, please. Top 10 causes of death. A study published in the Lancet, that is Global Burden of Disease 2015. They found that diabetes is one among the top 10 causes of death. Even if you could see the percentage of change in a decade, that is from 2005 to 2015, the death rate from diabetes is increased 35% fold. Earlier it was, in 2005, it was only 3%. That is, now it is increased to 35% fold. Next, please. If we look at this slide, there is a top 10 drug sales. In the top 10 drug sales, and the 5 drugs are anti-diabetic drugs. That itself shows the intensity of the problem diabetes. Next, please. Metabolic syndrome. What exactly is this? is the name for a group of risk factors that raises your risk for heart disease and other health problems such as diabetes and stroke. And other, even this, also the term is also this particular metabolic syndrome is also becoming into the metabesity and metabitis. Next, please. Etymology and definition. Next, please. In the year 1999, World Health Organization defined diabetes as a metabolic disorder of multiple etiology characterized by chronic hyperglycemia with disturbances of carbohydrate, fat and protein metabolism resulting from defects in insulin secretion, insulin action or both. Next, please. In the year 2016, WHO's global report on diabetes. Diabetes is defined as a serious chronic disease that occurs either when the pancreas does not produce enough insulin or when the body cannot effectively use the insulin it produces. When you look at the previous definition, that is in the year 1999 and in the year 2016, the focus has been shifted from process to the organ. In the earlier definition, that is in the year 1919, and the definition, the focus is being given to hyperglycemia. And in the diabetes, the focus is being given to the organ, pancreas, making the pancreas as the main culprit in this. Next, please. And this is an image showing the pancreas. And even look it from side, this is also this particular also simulates with our human tongue. More or less, the human tongue and your pancreas has, you may consider as a direct or indirect functional connections. How means, for example, usually in a layman terminology, we understand that why we find that there is a raised blood sugar. The point is, pancreas is not producing insulin, or maybe in other words, it's not properly producing insulin, or maybe the sufficient insulin. The reason is, if you try to analyze with individual's tongue, for example, if you consume one spoon of sugar, we feel sweetness in the tongue, and if you 2 spoons still and 3 spoons of sugar, again still we feel afterwards, and 4, 5, 6, 10, even if you consume 10 spoons also, you don't feel a sweetness of that, though the quantity is increased. And this similarly, the same thing happens with your pancreas also. As you consume very frequently, so similarly, your pancreas may not detect the raised blood sugar in the blood. As it is not detecting the things, so similarly it is not producing. That's how it has any functional connections with your tongue. Next, please. Nomenclature of diabetes mellitus is still relevant. The term diabetes mellitus was coined in 18th century when they had no knowledge of blood glucose or carbohydrate metabolism. The term truly means it is sweet polyuria. But now, in the contemporary era, when this blood glucose is known, the DM is being diagnosed based on the blood glucose only. But the terminology still we are using of 18th century. Next, please. Hyperglycemic syndrome. Diabetes mellitus comprises a group of disorders involving distinct pathogenic mechanisms with hyperglycemia as the common denominator. Instead of Calling this particular clinical entity as diabetes mellitus, it may be more appropriate to name this as an hyperglycemic syndrome. And still to be more, as you may consider as a metabetes. I propose this particular word, metabetes. Next, please. In short, we write the diabetes mellitus as DM. But even I consider this DM as digestion and metabolism. Digestion and impairment of this digestion and metabolism is the strongest factor for the causation and the progression of this disease, diabetes mellitus. What exactly does digestion means? It refers to how the body processes food in the gastrointestinal tract and eliminates food waste via the intestines. Metabolism refers to how the cells utilize the energy we have absorbed from food during the digestion. Next, please. Nidana etiology. Classical etiology and contemporary. If you look at this slide, the image how the human evolution is going on to. Next, please. So, considering the classical and the contemporary causative factors, I made an acronym, that is diabetes, D-I-A-B-E-T-E-S. D implies diet and dietary habits, and the contemporary, the many articles also get published on the vitamin D deficiency is one of the risk factors for the causation of the diabetes and chromium deficiency. And from Ayurvedic perspective, D is the dadi. And I is insulin insufficiency or resistance, intestinal microbiome, inheritance, ikshvikara. A, antibiotics and other medicines like statins, advanced glycation end products, asyasukam, anuparasa payamsi. B, body mass index high, blood pressure high. E, endocrine disruptor chemicals and hormones, endocrine disorders mainly PCOS. T, thyroid problems, E, environment, obesogenic environment and diabetogenic environment and environmental factors. S, sedentary life, stress, smoking, soy oil, swapnasukam. So that's how this acronym is introduced by myself. And this easy to, and it covers all contemporary and the classical causative factors. Next, please. So this slide shows that you urban and rural sugar consumption in India. And the interesting factor is the Punjab and Haryana are the two smallest states of India. But with respect to the sugar consumption, they are highest in. And the rates, prevalence and the incidence of diabetes is also more in these two states. Next, please. WHO announced in the 2014 that sugar is the new form of tobacco. Just as the tobacco is one of the leading causes of cancer, sugar leads to diabetes. Next, please. Guzzling water. Excess intake of water. People, most of the people have habit of taking 4 liters, 5 liters of water in a day. So, classically it is not advisable. So, Atyambu panam achirnakaram, madumehi jalam mandam achare, udagam kledananam, sratasiyata jalam. So, that's how these are the different aspects of Ayurveda. The guzzling of water is not advisable. Next, please. So, there are studies in support of that guzzling of water, drinking too much water can kill you. So, the study reported from Monash University in Australia. So, they said that 8 glasses a day is a myth. So, one should drink by thirst. Next, please. Coming to other risk factor, that is lack of sleep can up risk of type 2 diabetes. You can go through this. Next, please. Daytime naps of over an hour raise diabetes risk. Timely night time, timely sleep is important. At the same time, Divasopnam is also not advisable. Even if you have a Divasopnam, it should not be not more than a Muhurta, that is 48 minutes. Next, please. Daytime, another study reported from Sweden, Spain, Finland, and Germany. Daytime nap may cause diabetes. Divasopnam sarvadosha prakopam. Next, please. Over 40-minute afternoon nap ups risk of premature diabetes. That is again the study reported in support of the Divasopnam. Next, please. Sitting is, as we discussed in the earlier said, that is new form of smoking. Now it is another form of smoking. Sugar is a new form of smoking. Now again the focus is shifted. In addition to the sitting is also the new form of smoking, as physical inactivity as the fourth biggest killer on the planet ahead of obesity. Next, please. And this part, as you have then a sedentary habits, if you look at this image, left side brain after sitting quietly and the right side brain after 20 minutes walk. So that's how the walking causes an increased circulation. Next, please. Use of antibiotics may lead to diabetes study. So there is a study reported. So this is one of the causative factor and the risk factor. The chronic use of antibiotics disturbs the human microbiome. That is also leading to the diabetes in due course. Next, please. Statins and diabetes risk. And you know, the people use statins for years together, and there are studies reported on the risk of long-term use of statins leads to the diabetes. Next, please. And these days, we could see this particular non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. This also in due course is developing into the diabetes. Next, please. Dr. Marcia Angel, a senior Harvard lecturer and former head of New England Journal of Medicine, she said that medical corruption is also one of the factor for the increased diabetes prevalence. In her terms, it is simply no longer possible to believe much of the clinical research that is published or to rely on the judgment of trusted physicians or authoritative medical guidelines. I take no pleasure in this conclusion, which I reached slowly and reluctantly over my 2 decades as an editor of the New England Journal of Medicine. Next, please. Pathophysiology, that is Samprapti, shifting from triumvirate to the ominous octet. You know, the blood sugar is the world's greatest scapegoat, and most of the conditions directly or indirectly and almost all the systems are being affected by the raised blood sugar. Next, please. Earlier days, the pathogenesis of type 2 diabetes is considering this triumvirate, that is maybe impaired glucose secretion, maybe the increased hepatic glucose production, maybe the decreased glucose uptake by the pancreas, by the muscles, impaired insulin secretion by the pancreas. And the focus is being shifted from triumvirate to ominous octet. Almost these are 8 different pathological mechanisms which leading to the causation of the disease. Maybe decreased insulin secretion, decreased incretin effect, increased lipolysis, increased glucose reabsorption, decreased glucose uptake, neurotransmitter dysfunction, increased hepatic glucose production, increased glucagon secretion. So that's how these are 8 pathological mechanisms leading to the causation of the disease. Next, please. Purvarupa. This may be the pre-diabetes and the next diabetes. Next, please. In Ayurveda, pre-diabetes was beautifully detailed and described. Gamanat sthanam, sthanat asanam, asanat shayanam, shayanat swapnam. Tends to, gamanat sthanam, which means tends to stay while walking. If any person is in the pre-diabetic phase, if he is walking for some distance, so he feels that to stay for, stop for some time. Sthanat asanam, tends to sit while standing. If he stands for a while, so after a while he feels that, so he feels to sit. And asanat shayanam, and after once he sit down, he feels to lie down. And shayanat swapnam, once he lies down, he tends to sleep. So that's how this is in a series of events we could see in the people who are at the risk of pre-diabetes phase. Next, please. So there are contemporary studies also reported where how the pre-diabetes can be analyzed. The joint study reported by Ames and Fortis Hospital where the symptoms of insulin resistance, that is, they are likely to develop diabetes over 5 years. They are buffalo hump in the upper back, double chin, darkening and thickening of the skin at the nape of the neck, and the different images given in the slide. And the biomarkers, there is a study reported from John Hopkins University, Baltimore, where the characterized by increased reaction rates between the sugars, exosomines and proteins in the body. So this OG1C NAC modification reliable test to spot the disease in early stage. Next, please. Next to diabetes, that is hypothyroidism. Indian Thyroid Society identified thyroid as the next diabetes. And around 4.2 crore Indians suffer from thyroid related disorders. Next, please. So symptomatology. Next, please. Diabetics have false sense of well-being. And the study reported from Mumbai, so 90% of the patients unaware of high sugar levels, though some people even aware of that, still they feel have a false sense of well-being. Next, please. Symptoms of diabetes. The classic symptoms of diabetes mellitus are three polys, that is polyuria, polydipsia and polyphagia. But in the contemporary scenario, particularly in the urban and suburban practice, most of the patients report to us with as a symptom free, and they come with a blood sugar report, raised blood sugar report, and the symptoms are absolutely free. Next, please. Classification. Next. Since the year 1980, so there are different categorizations used, classifications are seen with respect to the diabetes mellitus, considering the criteria as the body weight, age, blood pressure, complications, treatment, and different pathognomonic mechanisms. And WHO in 1980 proposed IDDM, that insulin dependent diabetes mellitus, and NIDDM. Next, please. And the latest, which is contemporarily being accepted, is the etiological classification, that is type 1 and type 2 and other types. Type 1 is autoimmune and idiopathic. Type 2 and other specific types mainly gestational diabetes. WHO 1992 till date. Though it is being proposed as an etiological classification, but contemporarily individual subjects may move from one type to another in either direction. Persons who have or who are developing diabetes mellitus can be categorized according to the clinical characteristics, even in the absence of information concerning the underlying etiology. So if the etiology of a diabetic state genotype is the same, the clinical features of the disease phenotype are not always necessarily similar. Next, please. Ayurvedic classification. In Ayurveda also there are two sets of classification. One is a Krishaprameha and Stulaprameha, that is asthenic diabetes and sthenic diabetes. and other set of classification is sahaja the or basis bija doshada, and second one is an abhyanna mishra, genetic and acquired types. Next please. Complications. Next, the major complications are considered as a triopathy, that is affecting the three major organs: neuropathy affecting the nervous system, retinopathy affecting the eyes, nephropathy affecting the kidneys. Next please. Your reliable antacid may be killing your kidneys. You know, these days people pop up the antacids like in a office. So, but the many studies reported in the world's top journals that the people whosoever consumes the antacids for longer durations, it's affecting the kidneys. Next please. Statin use and risk of kidney disease. The long term use of statin use also leading to the nephropathy. Next please. Constipation, kidney disease may be linked. So people whosoever having the constipation had the 13% higher likelihood of developing chronic kidney disease. Next please. So diabetic dermatomes. So you may this particular condition may be similar with the prameyabetic and Ayurveda. There are conditions which may be exempted from this also. Next please. So if you look at this image, the left side image showing that this is an Indian style of wishing the people, that is namaskar, and right side a girl is trying to put an namaskar, but she could not. So because that is a complication of juvenile diabetes mellitus. Next please. Management. Next. In the year 2018, American College of Physicians published a guidelines, revised guidelines for HbA1c targets in the management of type 2 diabetes mellitus. The GS1 is guidance statement 1. Clinicians should create personalized goals for glycemic control in people with type 2 diabetes mellitus. Guidance statement 2. Clinicians should aim to develop their people with type 2 diabetes mellitus achieve an HbA1c level between 7 to 8%. Guidance statement 3. If a person with type 2 diabetes mellitus achieves an HbA1c level less than 6.5%, clinicians should consider de-intensifying pharmacological therapy. Guidance statement 4. In treating people with type 2 diabetes mellitus, clinicians should aim to minimize symptoms related to hyperglycemia. So this is more apt from the Ayurvedic perspective. Next please. Current management challenges. Optimizing the use of currently available therapies to ensure adequate glycemic, blood pressure and lipid control and to reduce complications. Educating patients on diabetes self-management. Improving patient adherence to lifestyle and pharmacological interventions. Reducing barriers to the early use of insulin and improving the delivery of healthcare to the people with chronic conditions. Next. Reasons for alternative approaches. Though most of the medicines are developed, introduced in the contemporary healthcare, still the people opt for alternative approaches, particularly in the field of diabetology. And the major reasons are the relieve or prevent treatment side effects, improve immune function, alter disease progression. Next please. Popular diabetes drug can cause side effects. The study reported and prolonged use of particularly frontline blockbuster diabetic drug metformin can lead to side effects including reduced mental abilities, depression, breathlessness and extreme fatigue. So that is the reason, and is also this drug metformin triggers vitamin B12 deficiency leading to neuropathy and microvascular complications. So where definitely the role of Ayurveda plays in a major impact. Next please. So Fiona Goodley is the first woman editor of British Medical Journal, and she said that Pushing diabetics to take insulin is a medical scam. Next, please. Diet and diabetes. Next. Diet is a part and parcel of the word diabetes, not only in the causation, in the progression of the disease also. Next, please. DASH diet. This particular DASH diet is popular worldwide. Particularly, DASH means dietary approaches to stop hypertension. And in the year 2018, DASH was named the number one best diets overall for healthy eating and best heart healthy diet in the US News and World Report annual best diets ranking. Similarly, also introduced proposed dietary approaches to start hyperglycemia. Next, please. So this is how DASH diet includes as per the National Institute of Health. You may go through this slide. Next, please. And the DASH diet, that is dietary approaches to stop hyperglycemia, how do we perceive from Ayurvedic perspective? That is Guru Chapatarpan. Diets are more advisable. Navanna is Guru Santarpana, Purana Shali is Lagu Santarpana. Nava Madhu, that is honey, new honey is Guru Santarpana, Purana honey is Guru Apatarpana. Goduma is Guru Santarpana, Eva is Lagu Apatarpana. So the diets, different categories of diets can be classified as Guru Santarpana, Guru Apatarpana, Lagu Santarpana and Lagu Apatarpana. Next, please. This particular acronym is introduced by myself, that is DIET. DI means dietary intervention, E means exercise and T means treatment. This is on a whole of Ayurveda, particularly management almost for every disease and diabetes particularly. Dietary intervention is Pratyahara Vihara, E means exercise and T means treatment. Next, please. Trayopastamba, this tripod of life, Ayurveda considers these three aspects, that is food, sleep, and self-discipline, life are the tripod of life. Next, please. Based on this tripod of life, I made a tripod of modern life for prevention and control of diabetes mellitus. Food is the same as the normal Trayopastamba and sleep is also the same. Instead of Brahmacharya, I have introduced the Vyayama, that is exercise, as a tripod of modern life. Next, please. Ayurvedic management. Claiming one medicine for diabetes mellitus is not at all an Ayurveda. Allopathization of Ayurveda, particularly in the management of diabetes, because more or less most of the physicians considering the blood sugar as a target and prescribing more tiktarasa dravyas. So consuming the more tiktarasa dravyas for longer duration in turn causes the vata aggravation, which results in the further complications of the diabetes. So be careful. Next, please. Ayurveda inclusive diabetes ecosystem. Diabetes mellitus, being a multifactorial disease, demands multiple therapeutic approaches. Diabetes ecosystem is exploring diabetes and its relationship with surrounding multiple factors in causation, progression, regression, complications and management and so on. Ayurveda inclusive, integrative and comprehensive healthcare model, that is diabetes management ecosystem, is only the possible solution to setbed. The setbed is reversal of the diabetes. If you read this from the right to the left, that is diabetes, and if you left to the right, that is setbed. That is to imply that reversal of the diabetes. Next, please. Conclusion. 80% of the premature heart disease, stroke and diabetes can be prevented as per the WHO. And the losing Indianness, that is India has started to ape the West blindly. This is one of the strongest reasons for the increased incidence and the prevalence of the diabetes in India. Health is wealth, but wealth is not at all health with respect to the chronic non-communicable disease. As you are more wealthier, you are becoming more sedentary. we are running behind the days. Diseases are running behind us. No hard and fast rule. Calorie intake should be balanced with the calorie expenditure. Diabetes education should be an ongoing process. Coming to the end, medical science has made such tremendous progress that there is hardly a healthy human left. So, let's take a pledge to make this India Madhumeha Bharat. Thank you one and all.